It's been a month since we set up this experiment, and there's some fascinating differences between these beakers. In the two beakers that didn't have any soil, all the oil has congealed into blobs on the surface and around the side of the glass. In the two with soil, they're completely different. All the water is clear of oil, except in beaker 3, where there's just a remote trace of the oil. But in beaker 4, no oil in the water whatsoever. So what's happening here? Have we actually got bacteria in our soil that can degrade the oil? Or has the oil just attached itself to the soil particles and is now sitting in sediment at the bottom? If there is oil munching bacteria in these soil samples, how effective are they? Your grease spot test will help determine this. You also need to get all the other soil samples that your students brought in for testing and compare them to these ones. Now let's check the grease spots. I just took one or two samples each time just to demonstrate the process. Obviously, to reduce the error margin and get more statistically robust data, you're going to need to do 10 or more samples from each beaker each time you do the test. Working on observation alone, however, you can see in beaker 3 and 4 that there's an initial decline in the size of the grease spots. This stabilizes soon after, however. My hypothesis for further testing is that the oil in beaker 3 and 4 is simply clinging to the soil particles, and there's very little bacterial activity happening to degrade the oil in these beakers. A further test you could do, you could autoclave or sterilize half of each soil sample. This will kill the bacteria in the soil and it'll help you work out if the soil itself is actually playing a role. As is the nature of science, there are many more questions than answers that have come from this experiment. The microbial world is a fascinating one, in which the myriad microbes play a vital role in sustaining the life of this planet. Hopefully, this prac will arouse curiosity and get students thinking about this invisible part of our ecosystems.